Hi, friends. Welcome. Today I'd like to read you The Night Before Christmas, which is a wonderful story about what happens on December 24th, the night before Christmas. This story was originally created by Clement Seymour. This one is illustrated by John Stephen Gurney. Thank you for joining Book A Day for Little Learners. I hope you enjoy this story that is a Christmas classic. "'Twas the night before Christmas when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled our brains for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer, with a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be Saint Nick. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donder and Blitzen. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop the coursers they flew, with the sleigh full of toys, and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. Had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk and laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod up the chimney, he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. Heard him exclaim, ere he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night." Please like this retelling of The Night Before Christmas by Clement Seymour and illustrated by John Stephen Gurney. If you'd like reminders of more of the books I upload on a daily basis, please click the subscribe button and the little bell. Let's look at this story again from a vocabulary perspective, as this story was written quite a long time ago and has some interesting word choices to it. The inscription on the page says, "A present for good little boys and girls." "'Twas the night before Christmas when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse." So when they talk about creatures, you can see some examples in the picture. They're talking about a cat, some mice, and then later in the story, we're going to see some dogs. The cat is curled up in front of their Christmas tree. Lots of Christians celebrate Christmas by displaying a Christmas tree and putting ornaments on it. And the ornaments can vary from shiny balls that reflect lights that people put on the Christmas trees to very simple natural trees that might have small candles, especially electric ones that won't burn the tree down, or birds, like just natural looking things. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. And so the stockings being hung by the chimney mean that most people that have a fireplace in their house have a mantle to it, usually a piece of wood or a slab stone that goes across the top of the fireplace. And oftentimes people display things there. And in this case, they hung stockings on the mantle. Stockings are another word for what we currently call socks. And each person in the family would hang one of their socks. And in the morning, when they woke up, St. Nicholas would have put a treat in their stock, in their stocking. So many people today follow that tradition with not necessarily socks that people actually wear, but with something that looks like a stocking. The children were all nestled snug in their beds while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. So you can see they're all tucked in for the night. Most of us sleep in a bed by ourselves, or maybe with one sibling. Most of us don't need to sleep four in a bed. And then visions of sugar plums danced in their heads means they were just dreaming. They happen to be dreaming about sugar plums, but most of us might dream about what toy we're going to get on Christmas or something exciting that we're looking forward to, going to a special meal or seeing family on Christmas. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled our brains for a long winter's nap. So the mom is wearing something on her head to either protect her hair and how it looks or to keep her hair warm, because this story was written when there wouldn't necessarily have been central heating. And you can tell he's actually using an oil lamp when he goes down to check on Santa. So both the mom and the dad are wearing hats on their head to help keep them warm, because the only source of heat in the house might have been from the fireplace, which wasn't in their room. So they have a nice quilted blanket, and then they have hats on their head. I love the expression of the dog in this story. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. So a clatter is like a lot of noise, like if you think about pans banging together. And in this story, quite often, Clement Seymour does rhyming, where in this two sentences, or really one sentence that could function as two sentences, clatter and matter rhyme. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. So when he flew like a flash, it means he just went really quickly to the window. And these are the shutters. And again, most people nowadays don't have shutters that move, they're just decorative. But a long time ago, shutters closed and they would again help keep the really, really cold or extreme snow out. So he opened these two, they fold open, and then this is the sash of the window. And so he threw up the sash so he could peek out. The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below. And so if you ever go out at night, you sometimes see that the moon is shining. And so how it reflects, especially on snow, it can make the snow look almost like diamonds. It's very pretty. And so that's what this is talking about, the moon on the breast of the new fallen snow. So it had just snowed that evening or that day. And then it said, gave the luster of midday to objects below. And so it actually becomes almost like a brightness because the moonlight is so reflective of this white, shiny snow. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and a tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. St. Nick, St. Nicholas, Père Noël, Santa Claus, there are many different names for this person or character throughout the world. And the idea is that although he's called different things, he is the spirit of Christmas in giving to those less fortunate or to those who are in need. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donder and Blitzen. So we know that there are many stories and even TV shows and movies that are made about Santa's reindeer, specifically Rudolph, who you can tell I didn't mention that, but Rudolph, there's a great song about Rudolph with his red nose and guiding Santa through a snowstorm. And so he's not actually in this original story, but there are many lovely stories about Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer and helping to save Christmas. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all. So dash away, he's just basically telling the reindeer to move quickly. Reindeer are real animals. You can actually see a reindeer sometimes, especially if you live in a colder climate, they'll have a reindeer that will come. And they are similar to a horse in terms of they have four legs and they're hoofed animals, but they are larger than a typical riding horse. And they have antlers, similar to other hoofed animals you would find in the forest. And there's the picture of Santa and his miniature Santa and his reindeer. There's another creature, there's a little red cardinal. As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. And so when you have hurricanes, things that are dry on the ground, like move very, very quickly. And then it says, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky, meaning when they then hit something or, you know, run into a bush or a house, they then go up. They go, you know, they would go up this way to the sky and they kind of get taken up in that wind vortex. So up to the housetop, the coursers they flew with the sleigh full of toys and Saint Nicholas too. So at this point, you can see Santa has gotten out of his sleigh and he has his bag of toys. That's a lot of toys. And then in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. So there are 8 reindeer. They each have 4. So 8 times 4 is 32. So he hears 32 hooves that are prancing and pawing. So making little noises similar to what you would hear if your dog was walking maybe on a tile floor. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney, St. Nicholas came with a bound. So a bound just means he came down rather quickly. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, meaning like he has fur on his hat, he has fur on his coat, he has fur on the bottom of his pants or the top of his boots. And all his clothes were, all tarnished with ashes and soot. So when you have a fire in your fireplace, and this would be to put your logs behind so that the ashes don't come out onto your floor. The ash from the wood or from the coals, it creates a black ash or soot that goes up the chimney. And the chimney is made out of brick. And so it goes up. And so this part gets quite dirty on the inside. That's why you have to have your chimney cleaned. And so Santa is coming down those chimneys. And so he gets quite dirty. And in this picture, he doesn't look particularly dirty, I don't think, but he would have black on him in some way. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. So a peddler is a person who's trying to sell different things at like a market. I love how the cat is looking at Santa in this picture with a look of surprise. And you can see the dad has come down the stairs and he has his oil lamp. That's what he's using to see, because when Clement Seymour wrote this picture, there wouldn't have been lamps that you just flick a switch to turn on like we have now. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. So a dimple is a little like a little indentation in your cheek. Some people have one dimple, some people have two. His cheeks were like roses, that means they were red, and his nose like a cherry, his nose was also red. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, that means he was smiling, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow. So the author is comparing his beard being pure white like you would see on the new fallen snow the author talked about earlier in the story. The stump of a pipe he held in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. So in this picture, the illustrator didn't follow the words exactly, but this would be an example of a pipe. Most illustrations, you see a pipe that's much shorter, and the smoke encircles his head like a wreath. I think earlier they showed a wreath in the story. A wreath is usually made out of greenery. And there's a wreath. So there's a wreath, and it's usually round and has a hole in the middle, and oftentimes people put a candle in it. But you can see, so the smoke would have encircled it, would have gone round and round the top of his head. He had a broad face, and broad means wide, and a little round belly. I don't know, what do you think? It doesn't look that little to me. That shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. So a bowl full of jelly, it would shake like that. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf. So we talk about elves being Santa's helpers, and Santa is the father, or the, so to speak, king of all elves. And I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. So the dad couldn't help but laugh. He just thought he was just too funny. A wink of his eye. So Santa winked, meaning he closed one eye with, closed one eyelid without closing the other one. And a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. So he kind of gave him a wink and then shook his head and was basically like, it's okay. And then the mom comes down to see what's going on. And I love how the mom looks kind of like, what's going on? And the dog is like, what's going on? And the dad's like, shh, just Santa Claus. So do you remember earlier we were talking about stockings? That's an example of a stocking. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings. And then turned with a jerk, which means he turned quickly, and laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, so he put his chin to his chest and made it go up and down, up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. That's what a whistle sounds like. There are lots of different ways to whistle. In this picture, you see not only the mom and the dad, but look who else woke up. Look who else wants to see what's going on. Do you think he'll be caught? Do you think Santa will be caught? But I heard him exclaim ere he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night." I hope you enjoyed that story. I was looking to see if it said when it was originally written. This one was illustrated in 1989, but the original story is much older than that. I hope you have a wonderful holiday season, and if you celebrate Christmas, I hope this Christmas story, whether you watch it the night before Christmas or before that, brings you great joy.